Facebook is hoping that its latest bright idea, Graph Search, will keep people coming back to its site. Mike Curtis, an engineer on the project, says the internal name, called Unicorn, on Facebook's sprawling campus encompasses what the team hopes to achieve.
Somebody was kind of joking around as they were sort of spitballing the ideas for this system that could search over the social graph and do all these amazing things. And they said, wow, that's kind of like a unicorn because it could solve all of our problems and heal all of our woes if only it existed.
The beta version rolled out to a small group of users in January, and so far, users can search for things like where other friends or Facebook users have been to eat, or search among friends who have publicly liked TV shows. What the engineers would most like to do is index status updates.
So we want to be able to index all the content for the posts on Facebook, possibly going back all 9 years that Facebook has existed, which is a lot of data.
It's complicated because of all the language challenges. That's where Lauren Chang and his team come in.
It's a place category, which is awesome that we have it, because now if you type in schools, because of Maxime's thing, it'll say high schools.
Chang manages the two on-staff linguists and three or four engineers working on language. The group is trying to understand how people naturally phrase things and let them search the same way within Facebook.
The computer industry trained people to type in San Francisco restaurants, or top San Francisco restaurants, right? And that's good, and it gets it across. It's very efficient, but it doesn't have a lot of specificity.
We don't have access.
That's it. I bet you that's it. We don't have that image.
To tackle casual language use effectively, the search term is assigned a number, seen here as a 15-digit code for friend. In this case, that number has so far been assigned to 50 different words for friends, like homies or besties. Then the linguist group brings users to Facebook headquarters and watches how they use search.
One of the big fun things has always been to go into the usability lab and watch people use it and see which of your assumptions turned out to be correct and which of them were wildly incorrect.
There are more obvious challenges ahead. The team is aiming to index everything posted on Facebook, every photo comment, status, picture, and more. Once that's tackled, they'll have to translate Unicorn into other languages. They're already encoding search phrases in a way that will help make translation easier. They're broken up by phrase, like restaurants I like, rather than a long new code for every potential search command.
So we designed the whole thing. The easiest way would have been just say, user types this thing in, great, take that, translate it directly to the search command, we're off to the races. But we took the extra time to say, let's chop that into pieces. Let's take each piece and make that a module. Let's translate each of those modules to a part of a search command. And that way, when we get to translation, it'll be easier.
If share settings are set up as public or at least available to all friends, search could make using Facebook a much more rich experience. From Facebook headquarters in Menlo Park, Carrie Davis, IDG News Service.